Every time humanity finds itself on the brink of destruction, disaster, on the brink of a great erasure, a force awakens that saves man and all of humanity. The light woven cross that forms the circle of life, God the Stara circle of victors, the invincible ones, knowing the heavenly reasons. This is the order of the protectors of humanity. The order of St. John of Jerusalem, Rhodes, Malta. The order of the Hospitallers. The heavenly army of light that was reawakened and is coming to Earth's aid. The army of the heavenly tribe under the leadership of the knowing Arlek, who ascended to God and gathered the bright warriors. The order of Alexander. We think of ourselves as being at the highest level of development. The illusion created by the forces of darkness is so strong that we did not notice that they completely rewrote our history. It is all 100% lie. The space in which we live is diverse. Man was driven into linear thinking. We have no idea where we live, how our earth works and how it is arranged, how other earths are arranged, how the universe is arranged, the underground world, the undersea world, the heavenly world. We live in a prison where our consciousness and abilities to create and see the truth have been imprisoned. Everything was created by aggressors, invaders, parasites, who occupied our earth, Slavic earth, Surai, earth, the land of Surs, Rasis, Asis. The whole earth is one big nation that has always lived in peace. In the game of gods, which took place on our earth, the periods of day and night of Svarok alternated. When the light forces lost their power for a certain time, and thus an imbalance occurred. In the most difficult and longest night of Svarok, which ended in 1996, also known as the Kali Yuga, in the last 1008 years, when based on the conditions of the game of gods, all beings who had reached the divine level had to leave our earth. Our enemies reprogrammed everything they could to destroy us completely. The view of the future always looked the same: destruction and extermination. When humanity can no longer see a way out and degradation is at its highest level, at the time when the enemy uses forbidden weapons, manipulates the will of man and is about to make the final blow, when the oldest order in history awakens, whose task has always been to protect humanity from complete destruction, listen to the truth about the power of the Knights of the Order of St. John of Jerusalem, Rhodes, Malta, the Supreme Order of the Hospitallers, the Slavs, to whom the whole earth belongs. The Order of St. John has ancient roots. Those roots go back to the circle of victors of the goddess Tara. It's millions of years, not thousands, millions. The Order of St. John and its activities on Earth have their origin practically at the beginning of the creation of mankind. That means 1.5 billion years. Because the current understanding of the Order of St. John, those are Svarozic. Because John means cosmic cone of the heavenly God. This means that according to the cosmic cone of the heavenly God, mankind was founded and created. Time is the point of eternity. We take it according to the earthly perception of time. Since time runs differently in different parts of space, the result of this game was the creation of man in the image of the tribe of the Most High. The entire universe has been projected into man's consciousness, into his brain, even physically, into the human body, where the neuron of the main brain means the galaxy, in the macrocosm. God means Balshoy Agonь Galaktika, great fire of the galaxy. These are all the gods, our ancestors, Shuri, grandparents, and Prashuri, great-grandparents, who carry all knowledge. In the Vedas, it is written, the bright creators have gathered in man all the knowledge of the stars. We are gods. We are just still sleeping and our eyes are closed. Our thinking, which is imprisoned, can hardly understand dimensions. Therefore, everything seems to us as a divine perception. Then the question is, why was man created? Because at one time, if we take the Vedas into account, we will understand that in the Vedas it is said, open the gates of the middle world, walk between the world, get to know other worlds, but do not open the gates of the world because you will get in great evil, or you will find yourself in evil. In our understanding, the individual dimensions, as they also call it today, were controlled by gods. Gels, Lex, Arlex, White God, and Chernobog, Black God, were also among them. Chernobog, Black God, as the future Alec, opened the gates of the another world and let in energy from other dimensions that cannot be here. In a large organism, in other words, it is done completely differently, but this energy went through. This energy is called pride, and when pride went through, then those who let this energy, this infection into themselves, they all lost their divine balance. When they lost the divine balance, they began to deal with self-indulgence. They began to elevate pride above everything else, and in this way they left the level of Pravi. That is getting to know the peace of Ra. They were leaving the level of harmony and becoming fallen, falling. At the time when Chernobog, Black God, also fell, when he accepted pride, he did not yet know how pride killed God. So he began to envy Belobog, White God, that in the dimensions of the Belobog, White God, everything is eternal, both joy and light, etc. And with him, in that beautiful world of the lower Navi, in one of the most beautiful worlds of the lower Navi of Chernobog, Black God, where beings are born, where the particles of the supreme light manifest, which are outside time and space of eternity, there these particles organize their, into their circular dances. And in these dances, in these particles, there is the so-called jivatma, jiva, is being organized, and jiva will already create a system. And the system is already a being. This being then acquires its experiences throughout the Yavi, material world, embodying itself in the material world, in the dense material world, such as in stones, in plants, then in animals, and then already in man. So this is how the evolution of the being took place. Its levels were directly revealed, reached the level of the soul, and was already passing from man to God. Chernobog, Black God, did not want to wait billions of years of evolutionary development here in the Yavi material world. Why couldn't it be done immediately also in my Navi world? He thought. Therefore, he implemented a treacherous plan. He stole the knowledge of the light and used it on himself. Since he already fell and did not understand creation, he exposed the entire organism of creation to danger. According to ancient mythology, there was such a beautiful goddess, Isis, who had a close relationship with Belobog, White God. The Chernobog, Black God, infected her with pride. Isis, who had Belobog's White God's trust, stole one of the nine seals. It was the seal of the technocratic knowledge. When Chernobog, Black God, began to apply it in the lower Navi, the path of development became crooked. Nevertheless, with the use of this knowledge, for which it was still too early because evolution must proceed according to the golden ratio, and both the being and the consciousness must acquire knowledge equally, spiritual, moral, material, etc., and all this must be in harmony, then a person will not become a psychopath and will not use their knowledge to destroy life and all the living things. So in such a way that he introduced the knowledge, and from the moment and the lower Navi began to develop in a destructive direction. And then wars started. Wars began before the creation of man. These wars continued in spaces in the worlds of Yavi and Navi for a long time. This is how a civilization was born, which, when it reaches its peak, will disappear, because the golden ratio will not let it to the higher level of development. Therefore, Chernobog, Black God, wanted to steal all the seals and thus kill the entire organism.
В этот момент, короче говоря,
at that moment, Belobok, white god, called upon the world of Arlex, who joined in and came to Belobok's white god's aid. And it was the Arlex who crushed all the destructive gangs formed by Chernobog, black god, at that time and closed the Chernobog infected space itself beyond the borders, like a capsule, like a puss. So they encapsulated the space. The space is a very tiny in the universe, but very toxic. That space was called the infernal space. That is hell. There are 10,000 planets there. It is a space of 10,000 planets. In that space of 10,000 planets, those soulless, immoral, hellish civilizations were formed. They themselves have become hostages of this system. There were practically no living beings left there. What they produced, this form of being, are so-called EBR technologies. EBR stands for Electronic Protein Resonator. So it is not living cell. It is simply a primitive artificial protein that works by creating energy due to space vibrations and atmospheric vibrations.
It's atmospheric.
There is a beautiful poem that describes this event called Conversation with Farok. Darkness came to the creator to plead that the light does not give her a chance to manifest herself and pursues her everywhere. The creator granted the darkness her wish and ordered the light not to touch her. Darkness could manifest in the world of Yavi and Navi, but had not access to Pravi. That's where the rules and cones are. If that happens, the creator will order all his children to destroy and incarnate her. When the light appeared, the darkness became colored.
Как свет пришел, как свет пришел, как свет пришел, сиянье свое, сиянье свое, как тьма сбежала тут же, как тьма сбежала тут же.
The darkness has constantly violated the cones, so it must be chased and destroyed. This is our task. Due to the game of gods, our mother, Surai, Earth, was moved from the center of the Ra world, from the Aragorn galaxy, to the space where the isolated capsule, the Hell worlds, were located. There, the Dragon galaxy was created. The Milky Way, which is the only one in the universe as elongated as the Milky Way, in which the game of gods took place. The forces of light also had their own plan for the game of gods period, the creation of the fifth race, which would be the highest. That is why they moved the four tribes of the great race from the tails of the Dragon galaxy to the Earth. Darians, Harikans, Svetoruses, and Rassans. The plan of the evolutionary leap consisted in mixing these four races of the great race, the race of gods. But it is important to understand why the Night of Svarok took place. So this is where the game of gods began, where at the end of the one tail of the Dragon galaxy, it flies into the infernal space, where the infernal space beings are given access to create something in the galaxy that was created for them. And this galaxy in such, let's call it simply, such a super quantum computer. However, it is not actually a computer. It is pretty serious aggregate, a super quantum creation. And in this creation, in infernal space, through these beings, they gained access to life in the center of the universe. It is important to know that there is also Veles, that is Veshchiles, God Veles. He is the captain of the ship. It is the entire energy information field of the Earth and the universe, the great universe. And when in the infernal space beings, already through the human body, gained access to this creation, where there are already all nine levels, nine chakras, but today they can only reach seven. So when those beings gained access to that aggregate, it was said, even best demon himself did not expect how to become God in part. The Night of Svarok alternated, and always during this period the darkness created genetic experiments in its infernal world and produced its soulless beings, biorobots. One must know that Kali Yuga is always there beyond the Arctic Circle, beyond the Southern Arctic Circle. There are those already occupied territories conquered by the fallen Satanael and his brigade of fallen gels and angels. The angel that is the fallen gel. So beyond this Arctic Circle, on those occupied territories, there are already artificially created infernal civilizations where they settled and created their base there. There they commit destructive activity. There they have experimental genetic labs to create human-like creatures. This means that they studied how a person works in general, what a living cell is, what the creation of the Most High is. To this day, they have not even come close and cannot understand at all how a living cell works, how the cell lives and works. When the day of Svarok began, young energy came to Earth, which caused all beings that did not acquire soul and consciousness to turn into obesiani, monkeys. Judei, Jews, are also among the genetic experiments of the dark forces. They are also artificially created. They are the ones who sprang from Satanels, Adam and Eve. They are practically genetically modified beings. They mix the genes of the fallen ones into them, cross them with human genes. They thought they would gain some evolutionary advantage by doing so. At the beginning of the night of Svarok, they first had some dominance, but then began to degrade sharply. They began to turn into human killers, devouring people. This temporary effect ended and led to their complete destruction, because the creation of the tribe of the Most High cannot be interfered with in this way. To subjugate the humans of the heavenly tribe, the dark forces used forbidden technologies, including a weapon called Zerat. The frequency weapon irradiated the entire Earth and thereby destroyed the delicate spaces between the neurons, and people started losing their memory. Before the last night of Svarok, when the people were falling into oblivion and the intruders were sowing discord and pitting our clans and tribes against each other, dividing them according to the gods, at that time the heavenly army of the Arleks was summoned to Earth under the leadership of the Alexander the Great. No, he was not a conqueror as today's history portrays him, but a savior who united all clans and tribes. The so-called historians exchange him with Attila, who they also placed in a completely different time. Today it is already known that the Roman Empire did not exist in the period as it is portrayed, and not even to the extent that children learn about in school today. World maps from these periods prove it. It was Alexander the Great, whom we have also known as the Alexander Nevsky, Macedonian, Iskander, Genghis Khan and Tamerlan, who came to protect people on Earth. He united everyone into a unified nation. That is, the nation became whole in one god. God, Rod, tribe, who is one. There are many gods, but the only supreme god is Rod, tribe. When Alexander came to the city or a village, a settlement, he always asked the question, "Will you accept the one god? Otherwise, you will be destroyed." Those who accepted the one god, the god of Rod tribe, everything was fine there, and there was peace. Otherwise, they were wiped out. And so Alexander restored the order of Saint John.
He was a god, Cadmos, or as close as anything I've ever seen. Tyrant, they yell so easily. I laugh. No tyrant ever gave back so much.
Alexander, Vedushi, knowing Arlek, came to the aid of Belobog, White God. In the Yavi material world, he manifested himself as Alexander the Great. When the whole world was restored again, when the wholeness of the world was restored, when those rivals, those demons and devils were defeated, crushed and destroyed, then he issued the Universal Gramota certificate. The Universal Gramota, where he bequeathed everything according to the laws of war, that is, according to the Roman law. War, that's Rome. So according to Roman law, he bequeathed the entire earth to the Slavs. And this is being fulfilled according to all the rules of the game of gods.
I've lived long life, Cadmus. But the glory and the memory of man will always belong to the ones who follow their great visions. And the greatest of these is the one they now call Megas Alexandros, the greatest of them all.
When Alexander introduced the development management system on Earth, it was a model where the Vans, Vedushye, Boga, Nebesta, knowing the heavenly God, their highest enlightened priests, they were the four kings, the four tsars, Darians, Harians, Svetoruses, and Raisins. If you look at the map of Daria at the North Pole, then there you will see that in the center stands the mountain Meru or Mera, the measure dimension, which is the elevator of the dimensions, and around it there are four continents. These are continents, as it has been symbolized, are Darians, Harians, Svetoruses, and Raisins. It's like a map of the universe. It is the universe in terms of the cross section of the Dragon Galaxy. This is what we know called the Milky Way. Management was carried out from the center. So there were four kings, four tsars, and every 16 years they went through 16 circles. All those who ruled were Vans. They passed on the title of Ivan to the next Van, such as Daria, Darian, Karian, Svetorus, Raisin. Ivan means cosmic Van. In the center of Mount Meru, at the fifth point, was the Grand Magister of the Order of Saint John as the spiritual leader. So that's the fifth. The fifth is Tsar of Tsars, one that did not interfere in terms of detailed development within the tsardoms of Darians, Karians, Svetoruses, and Raisins. He saw to it and that the very direction of the Tsars themselves in this circle, in the DNA of evolution, which spins along a spiral, did not deviate from spiritual, divine, and heavenly development, so that the vector lies correctly and that there are no destructive manifestations in the vector's development of the game of gods and bright humanity. This is how it was all arranged. Descendants of the present day Maltese and Templars will remember these moments. They know the system. They know how the system worked. So the system of four tsars and the tsars of the tsars works as I have described it to you. The higher forces left this model through Alexander Vedushevo, Alexander the Great, who re-established this model of development, practically returned it to the earth for the harmonious evolutionary development of humanity according to the cone of creation.
На землю для гармоничного эволюционного развития человечества по кону созидания.
The Order of Saint John crushed alien invaders who wanted to take over Earth and destroy humanity. The center of their management was the Vatican. The Vatican was then located in Egypt. And it was right in Egypt, where the enemies of humanity were defeated by the Order of Saint John. Then their Egyptian pontiff issued a papal bull, stating that the supreme sovereign on earth is the Order of Saint John, and begged them on their knees to leave them on earth on that night of Svarok, so that they would not be destroyed, and that they could devote themselves to spiritual activities, and thus perfect themselves toward the light. However, as always, they fooled everyone again. However, their protectors who were tasked with accompanying humanity during the darkest period of the Game of Gods, during the Night of Svarok, the infernal civilizations feared one of our gods the most. He can destroy hell with a thought. He is one of our Vedic gods, gods of sunset, God Salim. God Salim is the Vedic god of the sunset, who always brings peace in the night of Svarok. And already, when entering the night of Svarok does not allow these civilizations of demons and devils to attack and destroy the bright human world. Then he accompanies them there and gives people and their souls the opportunity to adapt, to build protection, strength themselves. And then he accompanies them in the transition from a day to night, from a day of Svarok to the night of Svarok. That's why Yavan Rus Salim, that's why they say Shalom, Salam Aleikum, etc. It's all related to Salim. When the night of Svarok began, God Salim summoned all the demons at the crossing and made them build a crystal castle. Whoever refused was destroyed. The demons feared the god Salim, but he could not enter this night of Svarok, because according to the rules of the game of gods, those who reached the divine level had to leave. He leaned on his staff so that he would stand on 3 points when his soul leaves his body. When Salim fell to the ground, they still feared him, but when one of the demons fell out of the crystal castle and saw that Salim was unresponsive, they understood that he was asleep. At first they were cautious, and then they discovered that his soul has departed, and so began the longest and darkest period on earth. They abused and created trust. They turned Ivan, who united the whole world, into Ivan the Terrible, who murdered his son. They exterminated 4 civilizations as they sought the final step and total destruction. They were stopped by Stalin, who won the Great War and made the citizens of the USSR sovereigns. Today, we see the destruction of law, the degradation of human beings, the planned genocide of the Slavs. Civilization reached the stage of artificial intelligence and abandoned morality, spirituality, everything created by Creator. Now that the Night of Svarog has ended and the light has assumed its full power, just as Alexander the Great came to save the earth 1,000 years ago, today Alexander, the Tsar of Tsars, is here again to restore order. The time of parasitic civilizations that deviated from the earthly and heavenly stream, and the only thing they knew how to do was occupy, parasitize, rob and eat, is over. The game of gods that was going on in the Ra world has ended. The heavenly order is now being established in the Ra world. The head and creator of the Ra world is the Ra creator. The Ra creator now directly performs all the necessary functions to bring the entire world of Ra into the primary heavenly state, complete liquidation, the incarnation and transformation of all destructions into the constructions. Therefore, Alexander also awakened the oldest order of Saint John, and the knights began to act.
Орден Святого Иоанна Иерусалимского Родовского Мальтийского, высший суверенный.
The order of the Saint John of Jerusalem, Rhodes, Malta, the supreme sovereign order of the Hospitallers, is the supreme sovereign, is the highest military order of the heavenly army for the protection of the earth. Bright humanity, people, and the knights of the order are Svarožič, manifested in human bodies on earth. Today, history knows the Order of Saint John as the circle of victors of the goddess Tara. Tarj and Tara are Perun's children. They are the owners of the earth, brother and sister. The heavenly, divine understanding of brother and sister is different from our earthly understanding of a man and woman. Therefore, in the heavenly understanding of God, men and women are those who co-create. So Perun's children, Tarj and Tara, are the owners of the earth. In mythology, Tara is considered the North Star, located about the North Pole. It is the star of the goddess Tara. That is why the basic documented Gramota certificate, which has been preserved, says that the aggressors, invaders, parasites, who came here to occupy our Slavic land, the land of Surs, Rasis, Asis, in a conspiracy with the demonic level of the so-called of fallen angels and man-made beings beyond the Arctic Circle, in already occupied territory in the man-made paradise of Adam and Eve created by the Satanael less than 6,000 years ago, it should be known that Adam and Eve were genetically created. They are not born from the womb of a human mother. They are the creation of a genetic laboratory. Even then, they artificially created their invaders, the Dungars, and sent them here from the south of the Kali Yuga. Whenever the enemies under the leadership of Sabaoth and Satanim planned to destroy humanity, God Salim stopped this process by awakening the Order of Saint John, which was filled with ranks of Rus, Surs, Rus warriors. The Order of Saint John itself is a heavenly energy informational aggregate. Everything is preserved because the rod, tribe, memory operates on the proto-phantom level and cannot be erased by any technology. It still exists and manifests when the time comes. The hospitalers have gone through a whole 1,000 years in one consciousness, and this nightly consciousness is the creation of the tribe of the Most High for the protection of the earth, for the protection of children of the great race and descendants of the heavenly tribe. That is why the highest spirit and consciousness of Svarozic enters the night and then says, I am the order that is a light, woven with light. I am Van Rus Salim Tau, therefore the name John of Jerusalem. And during the night of Svarog, other names were added of roads of Malta.
How fine, dear Jerusalem.
God does not speak to me, not even on the hill. Where Christ died, I am outside God's grace.
I have not heard that.
At any rate, it seems I have lost my religion.
I put no stock in religion. By the word religion, I've seen the lunacy of fanatics of every denomination be called the will of God. I've seen too much religion in the eyes of too many murderers. Holiness is in right action. Courage on behalf of those who cannot defend themselves. And goodness. What God desires is here and here. And what you decide to do every day, you will be a good man. Or not.
The actions of each night show the presence of conscience in his human soul, in the heart, in the consciousness. Manifested conscience means that a person progresses to the heavenly level, and therefore nights with conscience are directly protected by all the highest powers. Any attempt to attack or even the thought of harming such a person means immediate retribution from the highest powers. Therefore, the awakening of the Order of St. John of Jerusalem, Rhodes, Malta, today means that the heavenly warriors, the heavenly army have come to earth to protect the earth, to crush all the enemies of the earth and the enemies of the bright human Rhod tribe, and to establish the heavenly order here on earth, so that the earthly and heavenly stream in the understanding of creation, according to the cones of creation, work and the bright humanity is restored here. To awaken the conscience, because the conscience is the heavenly system of Svarog, which unites all the children of the great race and descendants of the heavenly Rhod tribe. Sva means heaven, Svarog, Rok is an older name for a Rhod tribe. So Svarog means heavenly tribe, and Svarog himself, the heavenly tribe, is the one who created all the worlds and cosmic worlds of Yavi. He created Yav, and in Yavi, the entire heavenly tribe Svarog is already manifested. At present, the Order of St. John is the supreme sovereign, and everything else is under this sovereign. There has been no sovereign for the past 1,000 years. It was only a game of sovereigns and sovereignty. Sovereign, those are Svarozic. That's the universe. That is power, strength and responsibility for all living things. The power and strength of the sovereigns, Svarozic, is enormous, which was felt by all the dark families and infernal structures that have no right to live and are gradually all deincarnated. The word sovereign, the one who has already entered the heavenly understanding, consciousness, the heavenly office, as I call it, on earthly way, the one who begins to function in this consciousness, that is the sovereign. The word of this sovereign is fulfilled on earth because it is the manifestation of the heavenly will, the all heavenly will. And it is also the manifestation of the heavenly all reason, the tribe of the Most High. These people do not live for themselves. These people, Lubov, Dabro, Istina, these people already have the highest status on earth. Being already at this level, they think about all living things, all created things, and they protect this created. They also protect the bright human world, the world of nature, the world of the motherland, the tribe. The world of the tribe of the Most High means everything, including the universe, microcosm, etc. It contains all spheres of creation. The Order of Saint John created Rus. They also created Rasea, Siani, Ra, Shining, Center. During the Night of Swarog, they also created Daughter of Orders, the Order of the Templars, and the Order of Malta. They issued the Gramota certificates and granted them sovereignty. According to the Gramota, they are purely Russian orders and not Italian or Vatican. Gramota certificate is not just a piece of paper. Gramota is heavenly will expressed literally, correctly, and written on a medium that confirms this act. This creation is the river of time. That is why it is the sovereign Gramota certificate. So they got sovereignty, but they didn't get the sovereign. Since they only have sovereignty, there is also an agreement that the unified temple will not be further divided. So they all signed documents stating that all the property of the Templars and all the property of the Maltese belong to the Order of Saint John of Jerusalem, of Rhodes, and today also of Malta, that is the supreme sovereign order of the Hospitallers. Heavenly administration and disponibility is not divided into two, three, but there is only one on earth. The Order of the Templars are the Knights of the Temple of Mary Magdalene, the wife of Radomir, Isa, whom they call Jesus Christ. The Templar Order was always headed by descendant of Radomir, Isa. All the Grand Masters were his descendants. It was the spiritual order that built the system of construction of the organized being on earth. As for the Order of Malta, it was a military order, the Order of the Protectors, which directly dealt with practically was the unit of the world army, mainly European. The Hospitallers, since the Order of Saint John owned the land, gave them the island of Malta for their use as a headquarters. This territory between Egypt and Europe, they could observe and supervise the order and did not allow the enemies of humanity to raise their heads anymore. Смотрели и соблюдали порядок, чтобы не давали больше врагам человеческим поднимать голову. The white cross on the back background is the light woven cross that forms the circle of life, and this is the manifestation of the Order of Saint John, the cosmic cone of the heavenly God. The Maltese cross is shown as a transitional but is in red. The red cross itself appeared directly in the Templar Order when they killed Radomir Isa's wife, Maria Magdalena, Mary Magdalene, and her daughter in the temple in the north of Europe, where the valley of the Magi was located. Maria came from there, from the valley of the Magi, Magdalena. It happened in the cave of the temple when the knights of the temple were not there at the time. It was early in the morning when the killers from the Vatican came there and cut Maria Magdalena's and the daughter of Maria and Radomir Christ with a knife. As the red blood spilled on the ground and the knights of the temple who arrived late found them, they knelt down and made a red cross on their white cloaks. And they swore that they would continue to bring knowledge to the world and continue the work of Radomir Isa and Maria Magdalena. The work they preached and taught in Meteora. Meteora means Mi te kto ura, we are those who are confirmed by Ra. Previously it was located in Asgard Irski, that is in Omsk in Belovodje, on the Irtish River. There was a dome so the parasites couldn't get in there. It was an energy dome maintained by bright high priests. They obtained the Vedas, they obtained the awakening of memory. There the spirit of the rain god Tarh Perunovic entered Radomir and the spirit of Tara, of the goddess Tara, entered the Maria Magdalena. Perun's children Tarh and Tara are shown here as a husband and wife, but I repeat that this should not be confused with the earthly concept of marriage. Divine gods, which means big fire of the galaxy, God, which is a life-giving reason. It is now clear to all of you why these forces of darkness try to so hard to play sovereigns and created false orders and depicted crusades with white crosses attacking something and destroying everything around them. It is a lie, a perversion. Those are the Jesuits, tricksters, who put on robes and take swords in their hands and with the help of demons perform rituals on people. And they don't even know what the Knight's Cross means. The Vatican is a center of aggressors, intruders who came to learn from people how to acquire souls and spiritual skills. Although the Vatican is a hospitaler place, for some reason there is some destructive religious organization there that has no right to be a state. A religious organization that has no right to be a state and has no right to be there at all. It was one of the sacred centers of the hospitalers. That is why the pontiff always has a wise pontiff, his representative, who appears in a quotation marks as a Knight of Malta, in quotation marks as a successor to the order of the hospitalers, and in the quotation marks as a Knight of the order of the hospitalers. Only thanks to these representatives of the Pope, the wise Pope, this status, the in quotation marks of the white state, is preserved, maintained. In fact, this is all built on lies and deception. It was all committed by the Jesuits, who falsified everything, turned everything upside down and appropriated everything that never belonged to them and does not belong to them. I will explain it one more time. The Jesuits are one tiny branch of the hospitalers, young traitors who succumbed to the deception, temptations, lies and went on the path of traitors. Judei, Juzet, Jesuits, etc. That is traitors. They betrayed the order, betrayed the heavenly tribe and the bright human tribe. They practically betrayed God and the Almighty. So they are the traitors who are perverts. They lie about everything and always, deceive everyone and distort everything. In order to become a knight, a person must develop according to pravi, right, spirituality, divinity, morality, knowing that all his, her ancestors, shuri grandparents, prashuri, great-grandparents are alive, they are present within them and are found everywhere. Even in the heavens, all the gods and their ancestors, their shuri grandparents, prashuri, great-grandparents, men should thank them for being a child born on earth, where they learn everything and develop. Thank them and wish them that grandparents and great-grandparents, great wise and all-powerful ancestors open the consciousness of the person, show them the truth that is, to direct them to the path of pravi. So they learn the pravda, the truth, and follow this path. Sovereign Order of St. John of Jerusalem, Rhodes, Malta, the Supreme Order of Hospitallers is restored. The legacy of our ancestors in the form of the Ra treasure, from whose energy the banking system was founded by the Templar Order, is activated. The Order of Malta was a military order. This is how tribes, clans, priesthoods, kingdoms and states were created. And all this always belonged to the Order of St. John. It's all a cooperation of God's plan, managed by God's providence. Spiritual management and protection belong to the white spiritual boy. That is the eye in the pyramid that dark families like Rothschilds and Rockefellers are so afraid of, that they have spent huge sums of money to turn it into a new world order and a nightmare. In fact, the eye should be in a circle, and the complete image is the center of the Merkaba, following its corners. It is the eyes of Ra, and that is the source of life, without which nothing on earth would live. Its code is M0. Then, according to the sacral heritage of the white spiritual boy, M1 was created, which means materialization, matter, thought, Odin, the creator. It is the creator's code, materialization from the energy of the source. It is a spiritual, heavenly, and God's management. No civilizations, not even infernal influences, can reach this level. No one from the darkness expected that all this power would be gathered in one person. Knight, Grand Intendant of the Order of St. John, Secretary General of the Sovereign Treasury Monetary One, the 13th White Spiritual Boy, Tsar of Tsars, His Majesty, Alexander.
Сокровище Ра.
As the source of the Ra treasure passed into the Knight of Swarok, protectors were appointed. Those are the spiritually set descendants, not physically, spiritually set descendants of God Salim, to protect these assets until the dawn of Swarok, day of Swarok. The day of Swarok and the handing over of these assets to already manifested Rusis. These protectors, in short, the family of protectors, have always protected and preserved the connection with these energies, with these spiritual assets, which are located more than 10 kilometers below the Earth. You can't get there using any infernal technology, because there is a space-time generator placed there that closes the passages. In short, only those who have access can get there. That's where these energies flow. That's where the word asset comes from. That's the energy. That is the source. The source that forms the golden ratio of space, the space of life and the entire matrix. White Spiritual Boy is a mission. The mission that was outlined, and the White Spiritual Boy, that is the White Tsar, the Tsar of Tsars. The Tsar of Tsars is coming to restore order in the world, to remove all the destruction after the Game of Gods, after the Night of Svarok, and to restore the right cosmic system. Following Alexander's activation of the Supreme Sovereign, the Order of St. John, at the end of the Game of Gods, the Hospitallers immediately sprang into action. The Knights have deincarnated the infernal worlds and are establishing order everywhere, even beyond the Arctic Circle. They took over the financial system and established the new World Sovereign Bank, the World Sovereign Bank of the Order of Hospitallers, which is headquartered in Bratislava. Every time the Knights of the Order of Hospitallers came, they also brought a new way of financing or a financial system throughout culture. Understand that there is no other way. The Knights of the Order of Hospitallers control all the world's assets. The heavenly inheritance that manifests itself after the Game of Gods has the following sequence. First comes the Tsar of Tsars, Father. He establishes order. And then comes the Tsar of Glory. The Tsar of Glory is the owner of the earth, Tsar Perunovich, Isa Radomir. The Knights of the Order of Hospitallers will fulfill their mission. They fulfilled it. They will also continue to fulfill it. They are the ones who will divide, and they will also determine the rules by which we will live, so that we live according to pravi, according to truth, justice and love. Now the Knights are starting to wake up. They are starting to realize who they are, quietly, because all limiters, all problems, all limits, all axioms of impossible, which do not exist, are only in the mind, in the head of a person. One still needs time to throw off those shackles and to open up completely. Everything leads to that. That is why the ancient order is awakening. The whole divine plan and the great providence carry out everything according to pravi, according to cons, according to the Almighty. Con is a word, an original idea from the tribe of the Most High, Almighty, according to the original idea. Everything is interconnected. There are no separate parts. It is in the world there are no separate parts. Everything in the world must now be systematized according to pravi. There must be a heavenly system. People should open themselves to cetometric divine thinking, etc. That will already be an open divine level. The creators do not have unnecessary details. They structure everything correctly, transform everything correctly, reshape it. And if there is somewhere, something, someone, then sorry, a cruel transformation can also take place. A path to the incarnation or of these beings that work destructively and do not want to change, correct, then we are obliged to fulfill the cosmic heavenly cone, which says that there is no need to save what doesn't not want, wish to be saved. Люди богов ведают means love. The word is creation. All these heavenly words of creation, and it must be understood that we are one whole. We are united. Our happiness lies in our union and in our bond, in our mutual help. Helping someone, even for free, without money, is a good deed. That is a deed that has heavenly value. It is a heavenly creation and heavenly deed. Mutual help, mutual profit, cooperation. Universal salvation. No one can save themselves on their own. You can save yourself only in unification. Salvation is in union, unification. The heavens are wholeness. Nebesa, heavens, where there is no best demon, where there is no division, and people, humans, mankind must come to such a unified understanding, realization that we are all whole. We are all children of tribe of the Most High Almighty, and we must all be brothers and sisters, a great family in our common temple of love, both on earth and in heaven.
A king may move a man. A father may claim a son. That man can also move himself. And only then does that man truly begin his own game. Remember that howsoever you are played or by whom, your soul is in your keeping alone. Even though those who presume to play you be kings or men of power, when you stand before God, you cannot say, "But I was told by others to do thus," or "that virtue was not convenient at the time. This will not suffice." Remember that.
The order of our ancestors, the Prashuri, the great-grandparents, has awakened. We are the children of the tribe. We are not soulless beings. It only depends on our decision whether we will stand by Alexander and the knights of the oldest sovereign order of St. John, the Order of Hospitallers. And together with them, we will unite all clans and tribes into one whole. Let's build a bright future for our tribes, build on truth, justice, and conscience.